I've detected a rapid increase in energy output from the planetary fortress's jerk matter reactor.
Oh, they're fixing the wallopers good!
Our target's that fortress. Alice, plot an attack vector, now.
Roger.
Wonderful 100, break through the armada and hit that planetary fortress. Full speed ahead.
Roger. Platinum Robo, boosters on max.
Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to Let's Play the Wonderful 101. What do you see before you is a tsunami of geathjerk, a fleet unto a galaxy, emanating from the Geath Star. Look at this. This has got to be the best looking Platinum game. And the frame rate only occasionally shits itself here, anyway. There are certainly some points in the game where it gets pretty bad. It will dip very low at the end of this section. But it's gorgeous. These deep, deep blues and purples. This swirling galaxy. Oh, it's so great. I think the space harrier stuff at this point is kind of overstayed its welcome now that we're dragging it into 9B. It was fine in 9A, but the scenario that's laid out here, how else would you approach this is the thing. I think they saw the opportunity to go, okay, we want to make this really hype approach to the fortress. We don't want to just skip over that, even though we kind of could and it would save time and it would tighten it up. I don't know how you would do that. I don't know. So we're going to take this goddamn dreadnought out with our big laser. Rack up all those big points. I'm not even mad that this is kind of not that well paced. I'm not even mad. You either miss out on the spectacle or you deal with a little bit more space harrier. They do kind of try to throw a wrinkle in there with these grids of lasers that you're approaching. And they get the patterns of the lasers become more complex and they become bigger and bigger distractions from having to deal with the Kalfoons and their projectiles. So they do ramp it up here. But all in all, not too much I could say. This is just a lot more hectic than the 9A version of this. The payoff, I'm gonna say, is super well worth it. And now that we have this giant wall of them in the background, they kind of try to add elements of Rez in here. This is something that it's very reminiscent of Rez, the laser grids and the giant wall of shit. And then there's some other stuff coming up that's very Rez-like. Oh, and these, this smaller version of Gimme's robot. Ugh. Oop. Haunt. Okay. Yeah, this should help. They teleported away the exact second I activate it. Just kind of trying to time that better, but... Nah. Now here we go. We're just one little lone Robo Platinum. Platinum Robo. So what are we gonna do? That giant robot that used to be a boss enemy? Yeah. To scale is now just like one of the little dogus to Red.
Dude, hold up. I have an idea. Right on. I knew that would work.
Blue is piloting a robot? What? He can barely pilot the coffee maker.
Guys, last time I was in one of these, I had a good look around. And being the bad dude that I am, I noticed something. A button on the floor labeled autopilot. So, yeah, we'll knock these babies out and take them over. Then we'll all be styling in super robots. Let's rock, baby!
Oh shit, let's rock, baby. I somehow never caught that line before. All the jokes in that scene land really well with me. Especially Pink's line about Blue piloting the coffee maker. It's actually a really well-written scene. So yeah! Yeah! We're just gonna punch all of the Gagujins as they come out and recruit them, just like the little dogus.
Attention. Giga Unite Hand, activate!
Whoops, I went to go get my water while that played. I didn't catch the call out. Whoops. I wish we could get some perspective of the size of this. I wish we could we kind of do with the Gagujin stood next to Platinum Robo, but I wish we could stand next to a building or something and just see the shit going on and get a real feel for the scale of this scene, because it's kind of awesome. So unlike the Dogus, who we could put in a near-death state and then recruit up until this point, all we have to do with the Gagujins here is damage them enough and they'll automatically get boarded and commandeered. Also, what a cool badass Blue is using an autopilot. More bosses that have become regular enemies. It's a trope I don't get sick of. Not being sarcastic either, I realized that the tone kind of sounded that way. Yeah, I actually really like that trope. The boss that just becomes a regular-ass mook. God, this is the coolest idea. Because it's like, they get you thinking with all the Space Harrier stuff and the shooters and all that. That like, oh no, you get Platinum Robo, but it's actually not that cool, because now what are you gonna do? You can't go back to your normal gameplay that you've been, you know, having a lot of fun with all throughout the game. But oh wait, here comes mission 2. Yeah, so they just throw the Gagujins at you here so you can recruit them and get up to your base 100. They do a great job playing with your expectations once you hit Operation 9. The entirety of Operation 9 is kind of amazing. This game ends really, really strong. Its entire final segment, its entire curtain call is just so good. That tracks really well. Huh. I think next time he does that, I'm just going to pull the sword out. Okay, hold on. Yeah. I even saw Harry in there. Ah, man, the other one's being a real pain in the ass from off screen. And I need to watch my battery just a little bit. There we go. It's back up. Team attacks really, really will help you out with your managing your Unite gauge. Good Okami. Good timing. I find Okami actually a little bit harder here because everyone looks so similar. Also, note that your main colored wonderful ones change the color of the Gagujins they pilot. We're not gonna go through the door that that P-Star is pointing us towards. Actually, no, it's not V-Star. It's the Virgin Victory. The Virgin Victory has become our P-Star because P-Star would be way too tiny to see. Yeah. So yeah, again to scale. That's the Virgin Victory for perspective. They do a few things to give you a sense of scale here, which is very cool. So all these crates have appeared behind us, but the big one you see in the corner is that a Kakuriga has appeared. And this one, let me see if I can remember. Oh, I can't. I think it's two of the bug bosses. I think that's all we have to do. So this is actually the second to last secret. Oh, no. Wait. Is there one more of them? I'm forgetting? Uh-oh. Hold on. I'm completely blanking. I think this is the second to last one, but I also thought there was... Did I do that one already? Ah, whatever. I'm overthinking it. Yeah, this one I believe is the second to last Kakuriga of the entire game. Actually, there's technically the hidden one from the prologue that we couldn't access because we didn't have the hammer the first time through, but you get the idea. I have to watch out using the dodge here because it leaves the mine behind and then the spike ball lands on it and I don't get a chance to shoot the cannonballs back because the mine blows them up. Up we go. So this is the same thing that we fought before. I believe near the end of 4... Was it 4B or 4A? And we have a pretty generous time limit here. We have a pretty generous combo score requirement. And the thing actually isn't that hard to fight. Or avoid taking damage from, at least. It's only got a couple of attacks that can actually hit you if you're on the side. It can either shoot the bombs right at you, or it can rain stuff down on you. Other than that, it tries to run you over. Just stay on the side. It's weird to think back and think that there was a point in time where I had a hard time with this enemy. But it's just... What a difference time and understanding makes. Really psyched them keeping this combo from before going. I haven't dropped the multiplier yet, so that should be good for the combo requirement for this. I think it's between like 8 and 10,000, which I should hit pretty easily. It's probably gonna reset here. Yeah, that's fine though. Try to end this here. Yeah, I lost track of that thought. It's weird to think back to when I first played this and the first time at 4B when you encounter this enemy, to think like, wow, I had a way harder time with this than I should have, but it's just the difference between like knowing its moves and knowing what your wonderful ones are capable of and just understanding the game. so we can come on back here and break down the final gate. And we can move on to another space section, but we're done with Space Harrier. We're done playing Space Harrier. They start off giving you really wide openings, and then they get really narrow. But the trick to this is, one, the holes go counterclockwise. Kinda. That one is in the upper left instead of the bottom left, but... the trick is just to get as far into the corner as possible, and you won't take damage here.
And dismantle the shield generator. Then it's lights out for the shield.
Good. We'll provide cover fire and wait for that shield to drop before moving in. Alice, give us a particle scan of the fortress and let P-Star know where that generator's hiding.
Roger.
Team, fall in!
Roger!
Unite glider!
How does this even work in space? I like how Platinum Robo was straining and sweating sparks to keep the barrier open. This is so cool. This is like peak video games. When Wonderful 101 hits its stride and it peaks, it is better than anything. It's like a greatest hit show now.
Bit off more than you can chew this time, Wonderful 101.
Aha! If it isn't the heir to the throne of the roaming Rulo, leader of the space pirate band known across the universe as the Geizok, Prince Forkin's first mate, Chugi. And come.
I think we're past introductions.
You have not yet left for your homeworld.
As it so happens, the crew had a change of heart, you might say. We shall follow your lead once again, Wonderful 100. On your command!
Roger! Wonderful 100, Chugi and company, team, unite up!
Roger!
So ideally, instead of mashing this, you want to time it. Because you'll die in like 3 hits, and it's not safe to whiff the Naginata here.
We need a human shield. Blue, you are the biggest foe.
Where am I? Oh god, did I... Okay! That's super weird. We are completely invulnerable to the Gagujins flying at us now. Only thing that we have to do now is dodge the res lasers. And that'll get interesting in just a second. Here we go. So our Vegeta homage, heir to the throne of the roaming Rulo and leader of the space pirate band known across the universe as the Gaizok, Prince Vorkin, has joined up, and we now have 200 people. The Gaizok plus our wonderful 100. And hooray for endgame Unite Morphs, Unified Boomerang, which is the same drawing as the gun, except with a delay.
Well, if it isn't the heir to the throne of the roaming Rulo, leader of the space pirate band known across the universe as the Gaizok, Prince Vorkin.
Vorkin?
Vorkin! Oh, no. Do not tell me! You came all this way for me!
So, you're here to, what, find a nice place to curl up and take a nap?
Why do you continue to struggle, Blunder Red? Your strength is gone now, it must be. How can one so weak hope to defeat an army so great?
I can't lose, Vorkin. There's strength in numbers, and I have an army of friends to fight at my side.
Friends?
I didn't come to chat. We're here to complete our mission. Team, it's time to take out that shield generator!
Roger!
Red gives Vorkin all that shit, but I don't hear him gritting his teeth. Oh, if it isn't Luca. Luca's a horrible monster. You join the team just fine. I think we can work things out with Vorkin. This part kinda sucks. These things have tons of health, but that's because they're intended to be hit with 1 to 200 person Unite Morphs. Bit battery intensive to draw that multiple times though, because the 200 person Unite Morphs, they do not last very long. Just like the 100 persons. Plus, with the laser spinning, it can be a little bit hard to draw them. So, that's no problem, though. Didn't take too long for that one. We have two more shield generators to go, though. Let's get Also, you might notice how slow things are. The game has slowed down significantly because it cannot handle the amount of shit on screen. Not just the background and the spinning lasers and all that shit, but 200 people, it's quite a bit for the game to handle. The frame rate has died. You know, it's really weird because sometimes the game speed dips and sometimes it's just the frame rate. Not sure why that is. Oh, that's only 100. Also, really, really easy to just parry those lasers as they come towards you. So you don't have to waste time dodging out of the way. Makes these a lot quicker, and they can occasionally emit that field that stops you from drawing Unite Morphs, or using them, I should say. And as it comes towards... Oh wait, slowing down. Is it about to reverse? Ah, shit, this. Let me try to get outside of the field and shoot it. If this doesn't work, I have another backup plan. Yeah, it's just hitting the raised lip of the pedestal it's on. That's okay. I got another plan. Oops. Yeah, why not? I'll poke it with the whip a little bit. That doesn't do bad damage. The whip is okay. Okay, now. We're gonna make big ol' unified boomerang. Because we can throw it at the shield generators from outside of the range of the anti-unite morph field. And it actually does quite a bit of damage. Plus, we can move around independently of the boomerang. Oh, almost there. Yeah, that's quite a long fight with not too much going on.
Well, that shield generator won't be generating any more shields.
Shield generator destroyed. Mission accomplished, team. Wonder Red to Virgin Victory. Virgin Victory! Come in, Virgin Victory!
Look out! The ground is caving in!
It is a trap! We are doomed! Mama!
We were gonna fight our way in anyway. Why not jump in? Take the shortcut!
Woohoo! It would save us from looking for the front door. What do you say, Luca? I'm in! I'm not running anymore!
The Virgin Victory won't let us down! Team, brace yourselves!
Run!
Geathjerk matter reactor.
See? Told you that would work.
Sometimes diving off the deep end lands you in hot water, no?
Plug it, Bastille.
Okay, the end of the operation is just right over there. Instead, we are gonna come back here to trace one last shape on the floor. God, I'm really bad at this. Anytime I have to trace, the gamepad is really handy, though. Tracing that symbol gets you the last Kakuriga. Yep, there we go. Finders Keepers, Operation 009. This one is, it's more or less a freebie, but it's kind of neat. And you'll see what I mean by that in just a moment. We have 1 minute. To defeat all of the enemies, we have 100 people, maxed out gauge, 5 pips of health. They're all Dogus. We have a minute to kill, I think, 100 Dogu. So I find the tombstone to be extraordinarily useful for this one. Of course, it consumes a lot of your Unite gauge, like 3 batteries at a time, I believe. But whenever you don't have gauge for the tombstone, you can just make a really big sword. And I should, since fewer are spawning in now, I should be close to the end, so I should come in under time. That might be the last one. Cool. I think you have 50 seconds per platinum on that. And with that, we have reached the end of 9B. All that's left is the very end of the game. Thanks for watching. Take it easy. Have a good one.